Hello and welcome back to my devlog. Today's video is going to be a bit unusual. My whole day was really busy and I didn't have any time to prepare for this video, but I still wanted to do this, so let's just start. Last week I was making an inventory system, which is by the way not finished yet, but it involved a lot of programming, and since I'm not a programmer, it was really tiring for me. So this week I decided to take a break. What you see right now is the main menu, and that's what I was doing the whole week. I was trying to find the best visual style that fits my game. Maybe it's not perfect, but I think it's good enough for now. First of all, I wanted to create some buttons, and since I can draw well, I decided to create 3D models and bake some textures. I opened 3ds Max and there was a text tool that is really simple. You just write some text and apply some modifiers and that's it, you have a 3D model of your text. Of course it's not that simple. First you have to find a font that is suitable for you and then you have to change some parameters of those modifiers so that your letters are not too thick or too thin. And when the result is pleasing for your eye, then you're done. So this actually took me quite a while, because I had no idea what kind of font I want to use, but eventually I finished it, and then I started to make a simple 3D button. Although it wasn't that simple, because I also added a frame. So overall I had 3 parts, the button, the frame and the text. Then I made the last part, a simple plane, which is like a low poly model, and it would be used for baking. After this I exported all the parts and opened them with another software, and the reason the main model was divided into 3 parts was because I needed to bake an ID map, and this ID map is used for masking different areas. I also baked some additional maps, like a normal map, ambient occlusion and curvature map. Then I opened Photoshop and imported all the maps and stacked them on top of each other in a specific order. I didn't really use normal map because it's colorful and the result should be grayscale, so I just took one of the channel of normal map and used it instead. The result was colorless and that's what I wanted. I experimented with different blending modes until I was pleased with the result, and then came the part where I would use an ID map. Then I placed the whole stack into the folder, and since my ID map has 3 colors, that means that I need to have 3 folders, so I made 2 additional copies of this folder. Then I used the ID map's colors to create a different mask for each folder and applied a gradient map inside each folder to experiment with different colors. I didn't really know what colors to use, but I really wanted to make some metal parts, so I decided to create a metal frame. My text would be golden, and my button, since my scene has a lot of green grass, I decided to create a green button. I still am undecided if this is the right path that I chose, so I didn't apply any hand-painted texture. I think I will change this in the future, but for now it's okay, it looks okay. So since I was happy with the result, I decided to create all additional buttons for the main menu, and they are basically all the same. The difference is that quit game button is not green, it's red. After I finished all the buttons, I knew I needed an additional background. I made it the same way, the frame was metal-like, but I didn't want the background to be solid color. I wanted to use some kind of a texture, and I decided to create wooden planks. But now when I look at it, it kind of looks weird, so this is the part that I'm most likely going to change in the future. And so that's it. that's all I've done this week. I know it's a bit slow, but I hope that at least I'm going the right direction. If you have any suggestions about the visual art style, you're always welcome to leave a comment below. Any feedback will help. So thank you for watching and have a great weekend.